Hello and welcome to the video build of Liam and Jess's camper van. My name's Craig Owen.
At vanityvehicles.co.uk.
Build. It's a 2008 van, a Renault Master. And as you can see, it's come fitted with an awning already fitted on the one side. It was a burger van and it's got UPVC windows fitted in the side. It's swing out. So it's got a big serving hatch. We're gonna keep the window. And we're just going to take that awning. Our first job we're going to do, we're going to take that awning off and fit it to the other side of the van. And so we're going to seal it up. I'll just show you how that looks now. So there it is. We've just fitted it onto the other side of the van. It's right onto the sliding door. And yeah, it's looking great. And the other side is back to normal. Back filled the holes. So right, so one of the first things we've done is Liam have cleaned up and give a respray to the trim and a little bit of a respray to the van. Just a rattle can, it's all just smarten it up. Just take out a couple of blemishes. And as you can see, the trim is looking a lot better on the one side than the other, where he's gone over with the fresh black. So he's just doing that to the van and getting the outside of the van looking pretty good before we start to the out, before we start the inside. So there's the outside of the van looking nice and clean. Time to make a work start on the inside. Make sure the awning is working before we carry on. So here's a pick of the awning, just out, rolled out. There she is. So we got it nice and clean. So the only other problem we had with this van, so before we can start on the conversion, there was three holes in the roof. Liam's gone ahead and fitted two skylights and we've fiberglassed up and patched the one hole. So let's have a look at that now. There's three holes already in the roof of the van. So he's fitted two skylights. Here you can see, just fitted the two skylights in the back and the big hole in the front, just fiberglassed over. And then over the top of the fiberglass, then we're going to fit our solar panel as well. But none of that will get seen. You won't even know the patch is there. He decided to keep the two skylights for a bit of extra light in the van when the lights are off. Yeah, so there's our sort of remedial works done. Now we can start on the actual conversion. So to start off, I'll show you some of the plans that Liam have brought to me, and he said this is what him and Jess really fancy. I'll show you some of the drawings now. So this is the first drawing he's brought me. And basically you can see what he's going for. He's going for a bed in the back, the kitchen dividing, and then a fold out futon bed in the living area. Ideally with a table just in front of the sliding door. Basically a partition wall where the kitchen is, going into a hidden bedroom in the back. Now he was quite happy, his night view from the sliding door for the forward look. Steps going into the back bedroom. Yeah, he was quite happy if the kitchen comes in an L, if it goes up and around. So he's drawing like an L there. Goes up and around towards the sliding door. But that's basically the layout he wants. He wants a fixed bed in the back, maybe with a cabinet over the top, and kitchen dividing, and a living area with a seat that turns into a bed for his boy Eli. So there we go, that's the basic drawings. Right, so as you can see in the diagrams, the walls are basically just a plain white, like. So we could either box the walls off in wood and paint it white or coat it white. Or we could use a white carpet. He's also got a lot of grey trim. So we've had a chat about it. Talked about how much weight the wood would add and how much it would box off of the van how much literage of space you would lose. And he sort of came to the conclusion the carpet would probably be a better idea, carpeted wall van. So that being the case, we've had a look into what colour carpets, and he's sort of, even though he likes like the white and the heathers and stuff like that, like it wouldn't be practical for the van, it'd get dirty really fast. And it'd get wrecked like doing so. I think the lightest colour you can go for. It's not gonna get wrecked. It's gonna be like a smoke, grey smoke. So we're probably gonna carpet the walls in a grey smoke. And then fit the 18mm plyboard floor. Laminate over the top of the wood effect laminate. And then for the ceiling of the back of the van, we're gonna do a sectional ceiling, like a ribbed sectional ceiling in sections, 12 sections. Trimmed in suedette in a light silver to match the grey of the walls. The kitchen then, we've discussed it, and he's gonna go for a light striped wood for the kitchen. We're gonna build the kitchen out of some scrap wood first, just so we can see how it looks in the van and decide whether he's happy with this, you know, the layout of the van before we go any further. But basically, the first thing we want to do is strip the van out and give it a good lining package. So that's basically carpet the walls, insulate the van, do all the ply panels, carpet all the panels, fit all the panels, do all the wiring that needs to go behind all the panels, fit the floor. And that's pretty much, once the panels are fitted, that's pretty much the lining package done, and fit the ceiling. Once that's done, the lining package is done, we can then go on with the rest of the conversion then. You know, installing the beds and the cabinets and whatnot. But first things first, now it's time for me to strip the van. So that'll be my first job now. Yeah, here we go. Yeah, so I used the van stripped out, and basically she's very dirty. She's full of holes and she needs to be primed. Loads of scrapes. Just needs a really good clean and a good prime all throughout, like any bare metal needs to be primed and get it ready for our insulation and our glue to go on. Like, so that's the first job. So I'll show you what it looks like primed now. So I used the photos of the priming work all done. All that had to be cleaned and then primed up, as you can see with the grey primer. It was filthy under there. You just had to go around with the primer and all the seals. Anyway, there was bare metal showing. Where anywhere susceptible to rust, anywhere scuffed up, just covered with that silver primer. And that's just done a lovely job. So we got a nice, clean, rust-free surface with which to start. So the first thing we've done is get some 18mm ply and start cutting the floor. You've got to use a full board and a rip to get it all to the width of the van. You've got to do a full board and a rip, and then another two bits at the bottom split into two halves. So four boards in total. Two boards cut into four pieces. Yeah, so then we've cut some 4mm ply and cut it to the size of each panel of the van, like cleaning up, boxing off all the panels, every panel of the van, every section. So applied, and that plier it gets fixed with the hidden trim clips. Just push clipped into the chassis of the van with the holes line up with the Owls in the play. The hard work is getting the play to line up with the Owls. Right, so we finished our play and put it to one side. We've gone back to the van now, and we've got a little bit of foil tape, and we just put it over all the little holes in the van and cover up all the little holes. We've got some foil insulation in, and we've insulated all the big panels of the van, like this picture. I didn't take many pictures of the insulation, but there's one in the back door. You can see in the bottom of the corner, we've put Dacron into the cavities to give us a good thermal insulation. All this is to give us insulation, and the carpet will go over the top of it all. Right, so I've done all the insulation, and there's a picture of some more of the Dacron in the walls. And basically, I've taken the opportunity now, while the van is bare, to put some wires in. You can see some of the wires I put in, but there's a lot of wires going through the van. It's like over 140 metres of cable going through and all. And yeah, you can see the last picture then. You can see there's loads of walls in the pillars of the van. And obviously, if I was just carpet straight over them, it'd eventually show through. And it'd get dusty, and it you'd see the circles. So I'm going to have to cover all them up with a bit of card and a bit of foil tape. And then we're going to insulate with foil all over the pillar as well before we carpet over them. And then it'll be the carpeting stage. So the first bit of bit of the van I'm going to carpet is this area above the driver's cab. And a little strip on the floor just behind the driver's seat. Yeah, so that's our first bit carpeted. The bit above the driver's cab, done in a grey smoke carpet. Looks pretty good. And the other piece then is just behind the driver's seat, this little strip. And that's also come out looking pretty good. So the next step in the build was to carpet the door. So here's the sliding door carpeted without the panel put on yet. But it came out pretty good again. Bit difficult to do the doors to go around all the sides. We had to go right the way to the edge because the paintwork around the door was really rough, so we wanted to carpet it right away out and right around the edge, not just carpet the panels like they do on quite a lot of vans. So it was quite difficult. And then we done the same on the back doors. And there's a picture of the back doors. So the next job has been to carpet the walls. And as you can see, we've flown over all the windows and all the panel holes. And then afterwards, we just cut them out and trimmed it back to the size of the panels. And there you go. We've put in some more wires. Basically, everywhere now that's not panels is carpeted in the van. There's a lot of wiring in the van. Put in quite a bit of extras. Yeah, so it's on to the next stage. At this stage now, we've taken the opportunity to put more Dacron in on the ceiling and put a couple of extra wires in for the lights. But now the old ceiling of the van is all nice and insulated, ready for the ply lining to go on. The first layer of ply anyway. At this stage in the build now, I thought it was time for us to knock up a template of the kitchen out of some old scrap wood, just so we could see how the layout of the van sits and whether we were happy with it before we go ahead and start doing it in real furniture. So this is an example of a little cabinet we knocked up for the L shape that would have gone from a sliding door and around to his dividing wall. And here's how it looks in the van. We've also gone ahead and just ordered a pre-made pull-out bed. A little pull-out bed that we'll use like for the futon. It's a little wooden pre-made base we found on eBay. We could have made one, but it was so cheap and it didn't really need to be particularly custom for the van. This particular thing is just a little square base with some doors in it. So we picked up one of them cheap on eBay. It didn't come with anything on top, but Liam I've just found a find. Someone was throwing out this mattress topper, and with the folding and everything, it fits perfectly. We need to trim a little bit off the back, like, but it pretty much fits perfectly. And they were just getting rid of it, and it's literally exactly what we wanted. To buy something like this in would have been quite expensive, like on top of the build. But we've had that for free, so it's a nice mattress topper. So at this stage in the build now, we know pretty much where our futon bed's going to end up. We know where the kitchen's going to end up, and we know how the final layout of the van is going to be. And Liam have decided, I had a little think about it. First of all, he was happy, and he thought about the gap he'd have to get to the hidden bedroom through the dividing wall. He's happy. But then he sort of thought, right, I'm going to have a night to think on it. He's gone home, he's woke up the next day, and he's thought, right, no. He wants to change the design of the van. He wants to do away with the dividing wall, do away with the L-shaped kitchen, and go for a more open plan van. So you can still see the back doors. He likes the back doors the way they've turned out. He wants to be able to see the full length of the van at all times. So what we're doing, the dividing wall is still going to be there, but it's only going to be as high as the bed. And the L-shaped kitchen that was originally going to be dividing the living area and the bedroom is now going to be a straight kitchen. But because we got the hob and the sink and the fridge and everything ready for the original L-shaped kitchen, the kitchen, if we're going in a straight line, it's going to have to come out, fly past the sliding door so far, so you can fit it all in. But Liam have said he would prefer that and go with an open plan, so it's a bit of a change of plans. He's had a picture, he sent me a picture of a van he likes. So here's a picture of a van that is very similar to the design he's going for. Obviously, it'll be our colour scheme, so it'll be a different colour scheme. But yeah, this sort of layout, like without the shower cubicle, without the overhead cabinets over the top of the futon bed, but pretty much very similar to this layout. So it's not too much of an issue, like, but we can, it's just a bit of a change with plans, like, so it's time for me to crack on with that.
Right, so the next job has been to cut the lino for the floor. So he's gone for this herringbone check lino floor. So we've just laid it out on top of our 18mm ply floor that we've already cut the shape of the van. Just laid it down and just trimmed around the edge. Really is as simple as that. And then it's just a case of laying the wood floor back in the van, fixing it down, and then glue fixing the lino over the top. And that's give us a lovely herringbone check finish. Lovely. Onwards and upwards. The next job now is the ceiling. So we've screw fixed a bit of ply to the ceiling. This is going to be our backing board for our ceiling. We've just wired in our electrics ready for where our LEDs are going, and we've cut around those two skylights. And we've just got a nice solid backing board now, which we're going to fix our ribbed trimmed ceiling to, which should come out looking really nice. So I'll just show you some pictures of that being cut now, and I'll show where it's been installed. Ah, and it's come out looking lovely. Really nice. So the next job now is to get those panels that we've already carpeted now, and get them all fitted on the side. Get all the panels fitted. And show you how that looks now. Yeah, so as you've just seen, we tiled over a little patch of where his kitchen is going to be. We've started putting in some electrics, some lights, some wires for the USB. There's a big wires, a bunch of wires there to go to the PMS unit. A lot of wiring has gone in behind there before this stage. So we're looking good. So it's time to start making a bed, I think.
So we started making the bed. Basically made the bed frame out of some 4x1. And made some legs out of some 4x4. Carpeted the legs. And just screw fixed it all into place. Ready, there'll be loads of brackets and stuff holding it in position by the time it's finished. So it's plenty strong enough. Just basically just make a bed frame. We'll cover it with some pine slats. And it'll just be a case of putting a mattress over the top. So you can see the height of the bed and how much of a boot space he's got underneath it. It's exactly the height that Liam wanted it like. So he's happy. Right, so the next job we've done is started making the overhead cabinets. So you can see you've got two storage compartments, a microwave all and a hole for the PMS unit. And we've scribed the side of it to the side of the shape of the van and fitted it. The side of the van is slightly sloping and we've kept it coming straight off the van, so the cupboard is slightly sloping down and the ceiling curves up, so it doesn't quite match up with the front of the ceiling, so we're going to put a pelmet around the front. But with the height of the van, it just worked out a bit more comfortable for access to the PMS unit and the overhead cabinets, like having it down at a little bit of an angle, same angle as the wall. We scribed it all in and fitted it to the side of the wall using nutserts to screw it, bolt it to the wall. So I'll fix it coolly now. And as you can see underneath, all the 12-volt lighting has lined up lovely underneath, and we've installed some LEDs at the same spacings as would be on the roof on the underside of the overhead cabinet. So it's going really well. It's just the doors to be put on, you know.
Right, so we've come in with this dividing wall made out of the same striped wood as his cabinets and put it to divide between the cabinets and the bed. And we've installed the bed. You can see the bed is sitting on some pine slats. We've got a custom made mattress made. So yeah, it's looking pretty good. So at this stage we've taken the time to install the power management system and started coming in with the cabinets. We've started to fit the cooker and the sink. It needs a bit of wiring. But you can see the cutout of the work surface. Then it was time to install some doors on the cabinets and go ahead and start making some drawers. And we've cut out the gas dropout vent and wired the cooker and the waste pipes. So yeah, it's coming along lovely. We just fitted all the water cabinets and the gas bottle underneath into the cabinet. And there you can see it all being routed lovely. And the waste routed out through the floor. So yeah, it's just a case of putting some drawer faces on now, installing the fridge and the microwave. And you can see on this final dividing wall, and we've gone and fitted the solar panel charge controller and the controller for the diesel heater. So that's great. It's just really getting towards finishing touches now with the van, like.
So we trimmed the carbed liner in the same suede as we used for the rest of the ceiling. And that's come out really good. and just spent a bit of time rebuilding the cab, wiring up the split charger, just doing final touches on the van, like put a little cover over the battery box, just little bits and bobs. And now we can really see the van has come together and this is how it looks finished. Oh.